Right, don't worry about the dragon, Wes. Dragons can't hurt you. They're as scared of you as you are of them. Look. Sneak under his taint and we're off. Let's grab those 193 runes. Never know when they might come in handy. Now, it's towards the Erd Tree, yes? Maybe. Or was there another site of grace somewhere near the other side of this bridge? I also forget if that was the case. There's kind of a tower over there. And a tomb. Many tombs. So I guess we'll snag these runes again. 6 and an 8. Oh yeah, that's the rise, isn't it? With the Sight of Grace down there. May as well grab it, just because we're in the vicinity. We might need it later. Now, what even is the deal with this town? There was a thing nearby, wasn't there? So we've got this tower. We've got a Spirit Spring. Can we jump into the tower? Maybe. It did look like there was a sort of windowsill up there, didn't it? Yeah, it's kind of balcony there. On the roof and then... No, you just sort of fall through it by the look. Which is odd, because it looks like I should just slide off the roof and land on it. But that doesn't seem to be the case. There we go. I thought something was going on here. Now we can just ride our horse around in the tower, that's nice. May as well see what treasures it holds at this point. It's got an elevator, that's cool. And up we go, to something. Flight of stairs, up we go further, and... Is this the end? It's a treasure chest, nice. Oh, it's a memory stone. Lovely. Oh yeah, that might be the loot that you get in these types of towers, if I'm right. They all hold memory stones, and memory stones increase the number of spells you can cast. So... That would be useful if we were playing as a character that intended to cast any spells whatsoever. But at least we know now how to get up there, so... Very good. I know that there's others where you've got to, like, kill nearby beasts and whatnot to get in. But that's kind of cool. Is the seal going to be broken on the door now, or are we just going to have to jump out of a window to get out? Oh god, what you? I didn't ask for a big blobby thing. God, you got health. Hopefully you don't have any attacks more serious than a bit of blue mist. Because if that's the case, then yeah, maybe we'll just wail on you for a bit. I'm kind of worried about what will happen if it hits us at any point. Whether we will get one shot. It's just a big ball of faces. It's a cool design. Seems to be making murmuring noises, although it stops when I give it a savage beating. What have I got? Upward cut. Ah, that's how that works. So you do the upward cut with L2, and then you can follow it up with a stamp. Wait, you do the stamp with L2, and then you can follow it with an upward cut. With R2, but not R1. Good to know. No! Oh my goodness, if we just died there at the very end, that would have been saddening. But we got it, and we earned ourselves most of a level's worth of runes, probably. That's nice. Now, are you holding open the seal, or is the seal still sealed? The seal remains sealed, so I guess that was just largely pointless except for the runes. That's cool. Vigor. It's got to be Vigor. Wes's defensive strategies basically involve tanking everything with his big, beautiful face. And yeah, probably back up the spring and carry on in a general southwesterly direction. Yeah, yeah, we're heading back towards and then past the oak tree. It's all coming together in my brain, slowly. Nice looking beach. Got quite the party out there. What's that tower? It's impressive. Hard to tell if it was connected to anything via a bridge at any point, or if it wasn't. But either way, we'll sidestep the boss. We haven't sidestepped it quite well enough, but we're just going to cheese it. He looked like a fat boy. He's probably not going to follow us very far. Although, yeah, that lightning. That's unpleasant. That's a big old scarab. Also, it's way too healthy for us to take on right now. Is that the dragon we need? Nope, it's just some lumps of rot on a branch. That's cool. But there are dragons around and about. So we're kind of in the vicinity of where we should be. Because yeah, there's our big burning wall, and there's our dragon. So we should have just headed straight towards this castle, probably. Is this castle more? Yeah, I think it is.
Nope!
Dragons. A glowing red eyes dragon. Some Dragon Ball shears right there, possibly. I'm not a Dragon Baller. Now, what are those buffs and debuffs under my character profile there? Sword down, armor down, meat up. Is that something to do with my talisman, perhaps? Increased stamina recovery speed, so possibly that's part of it, but I don't understand why sword down or armor down would be things. Stasis, does that tell us? Doesn't seem to tell us. Swap screen. No. We'll have to figure that out at some point. Not sure if one-handing or two-handing's best here. Possibly one-handing, because I think they'll both apply the same amount of bleed buildup. But one-handing uses less stamina. Could be wrong. Now, can we afford... Ah, some of our buffs have worn off, that's good. Don't know what caused them. wasn't on handling the weapon, was it? No. But either way, let's use our pickled foot, because now's probably the time. Because he's probably only got one more bleed in him. Yeah, we've got those debuffs back. Is it one of the other dragons yelling at us and thus reducing our stats? It seems to relate to that red aura. And yeah, that one more bleed didn't kill him, so let's just keep wailing away. Maybe we'll just get him with regular damage before the next bleed. But I'm sure we'll get him before our foul foot wears off. There we go. Dead dragons everywhere. And some dragon hearts. I don't actually know if the dragon hearts are of any use to any character that's not specifically planning on being a dragon. That is something that we could look into at some point. I'll put it on the old mental wish list. But for now, we've got some levels to grab. And like most things involving Wes, this is going to be a no-brainer. We've got... I do want 18 dex. That is a requirement for the great bow that he's eventually going to get. But beyond that... let's get that much to 20. 20 vigor, 20 endurance, 22 strength, 18 dex. That seems fine. Wabam! Level 36. And we should probably go to Roundtable Hold at some point.
Very well.
She's going to be like, what the hell are you doing in Caelid? You're a tiny, feeble warrior. Get out of here. And we can probably put the old greatsword back on. Well, then we can actually use the flail now. We've got the 18 dex required, although we're not scaling, we're not getting dex up any higher. We'll stick to the greatsword, I think. And all of our friends are hanging around.
You've met Garank.
Oh, it's Deke. It.
Then owing to our duties shared, we are now comrades in arms. I think you've earned this. The power of the Golden Order to aid the hunt of those who live in death.
So you're in favour of the Golden Order, are you, D? What you got? The Litany of Proper Death deals holy damage. And we can enchant our blade with holy damage. Cool, I guess. Tell me about yourself, D.
I serve the Golden Order, that I might put this crooked land to rights, following only the guidance of the Great Elden Ring. Those who live in death fall outside the principles of the Golden Order. Their mere existence sullies the guidance of gold, tainting its truth. And so it is, the vermin must be exterminated, down to the very last.
Cool, good to know. So you're definitely all about that Golden Order lifestyle. Hello, old man. And you want me to find your servant friend? Have I got much else I need to do here? Has Wes picked up the old summoning bell? Yes, he has, good. And we've got some militiamen on our bar, that's cool. So we don't really need to do anything here right now, but we've got it open at least. Maybe we'll talk to old man.
Oh, this is a ring I can't remember well. It is.
He's got nothing new to say, but allow me a house. We'll just have a chat with him nonetheless. Actually, blacksmith. Maybe we'll level up this sword a bit if we can. Which way was blacksmith friend? There he is. And there's fear. Now I think I know what the Baldurkin Blessing does. Maybe we'll take it. Wes does not generally like to be held. He tends to squirm and demand that he's placed back on the floor. But Fia should be able to get away with clutching him for at least a brief moment without kicking up too much fuss. Right, what are we up to? I'm thinking maybe we'll put the buckler back on. Yeah, it'd be nice to be able to parry on at least one of the characters. Now, where the heck are we and where are we going? We're over here. Looks like we've dropped a rune pile over there somewhere. We've got dogs and jellyfish. Maybe we'll go get those Godric soldiers, because they could come in handy on Sam. She does seem particularly fragile. Got killed a bunch last time out. Partially by overconfidence, partially by dudes with big swords. Why are we just on foot here? What are we doing? Yeah, let's go grab some Godric soldiers, shall we? While I figure out what to do next. What do you have for us? A lance. Interesting. That probably requires a bunch of strength. 20 strength, 14 dex, but heck, that is going to be a good weapon for combat. Horse combat. Nice. And we haven't really got anything else on the go for horse combat for Sam, although maybe a katana would be nice. A katana could be fun. Now, is this where friend Alexander lives?
Hello?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Hi, friend. We will give it our all, and let's see what we can do to free you. Oops. This might take a few hits, Alex. We're not really about one big hit. There we go.
Ah, well played, good lady. Well played. Know that.
Ha! Mighty wallop. It wasn't really, but hey ho. And yeah, he's off to the east. Excellent. Yep, lovely. Good old Alex. Now, Sight Grace down there, isn't it? Not sure. Can't recall. Probably. Yes. And now, yeah, given the relative fragility of Sam compared to some of the others, getting those soldier ashes might be a nice thing for her. And there we go, the old Godric soldier ashes. That's just grand. And now it's just a case of getting to our dragon friend. We've got the bleed weapon, we've got the pickled fowl foot. Good times await. Ah, there's Mariner friend. Do we want to mess with the Mariner? I mean, we could, couldn't we? Hi friend. Do you want some stabs? I'm guessing you're not that bothered about bleed damage, because you are just an undead thing. But we can do some decent damage to you anyway with the old stabby stabs. Especially if you're going to take forever to summon your mates. Ooh, that hit. That wasn't pleasant at all. Now where have you gone? big slaps, that's fine. We can live with that. It'd be nice if our men could come over a bit quicker. Big explosions. We'll get there. One stab at a time. Whoop. As long as we don't take too many stabs of our own. And we could really do with you, like, knocking off your own lads there, just to make things a bit easier. Thank you. One of our soldiers is down there as well. But that's fine, because victory is indeed ours. Lovely stuff. Good job, soldiers. And another summon that we're not going to use, because we've got a better one. What's up, D? And he's made a red mark on our map. Fantastic. Now, what else was there around here? There was the stamina recovery thing, which would be useful for us. If we've got a stone sword key. We have one stone sword key, so that should be enough. One would hope. Some of the imp locks do require more than one key. I don't know if any require more than two. But either way, let's see if we can't get ourselves a stamina trinket. Let's see if we can't find the way to where we need to be to find it. There we go. Now, do you just need a single key? Perfect. Toy tools. Toy tools are fine. We'll leave them be. And we'll pick up their talisman. Of course that's why there's turtles in here, because it's a turtle talisman, isn't it? Yeah. It's taken me like this long and who knows how many characters visiting this area to realise that. What an idiot I am. A couple of spirit springs next to one another. Curious. And we've somehow got turned around and we're facing entirely the wrong way. There's our church. So, down we go. Doggos. You be good dogs. We've got a good number of runes about our person right now, so we'll just ignore them and head to church, like a good cat. Now, what are you? I mean, we know what you are, but which one are you, is the question. And can we bleed you? And are we going to lose you? Sacred blade. Okay. Probably not for us. Although if I can get a dagger for my offhand and apply like a different effect to it, like frostbite or something like that, that'd be kind of cool. Then we could do dual wielding for things that can't be parried. And where do we want our levels to go? I mean, we've got the stats we need for the weapon we're using. So, vigor. We've got four levels to spend. Let's put them all in vigor. Now we can head to Dragonsville. Here's your death route, sir. Just the one. That's all we got. I smell it, V. So we can head down this way. Get the next sight of Grace. Then maybe we'll cross the other bridge. Don't know why it just decided to tell us about sorcerers at that moment in time. Because we've got Dragon Bridge, but then we've also got other bridge. And the other bridge does lead us straight to another site of grace. It's nice to pick them all up, you know? What if we go around the left side of the oak tree? We normally go around the right side. Let's see if there's anything exciting around the left side instead. Whoa! There's us nearly falling off the cliff there, that's a good start. Oh no, we did come around the left at one point, didn't we? Because we saw that lovely beach. And then where do you take us? Up towards the castle? Oh! This is the quickest route probably to the site of grace we need. Nice. We finally found a quick and efficient route. After about 7 characters.